safe injection site for Victoria has been a topic of debate since the last of its ill-fated fixed needle exchange sites were closed down. Recent studies put the number of intravenous drug users in the Greater Victoria area at somewhere between 1,500 and 2,000. This sizable using population presents a number of issues.
There's the transmission of diseases, that whether it be Hep C, whether it be AIDS, whether it be some of the other issues around with that.
According to Victoria PD spokesperson Mike Russell, the Victoria PD are primarily concerned with the issues that arise after injection takes place.
Somebody will use, and then it's their behavior afterwards that typically gets our attention or somebody calls in about.
For local businesses, drug debris is a major concern.
Definitely used needles being left around in grassy areas, sidewalks, places where people walk and could easily step on one or come into contact with one.
A fixed safe injection site may provide a solution, but the prospect of living or operating a business near one is unsettling for many Victorians.
No one wants it in their backyard, so if you're going to put it in an area where people live or have businesses, there's always going to be a problem.
Vancouver's safe injection site has amassed considerable support since its inception in 2003. Victoria Mayor Dean Fortin has promised a similar site will be opened in Victoria.
I see a safe injection site as a necessary solution, truly. I mean, and it's about setting up and dealing with a level of social disorder.
North America's first legal safe injection site opened in 2003 in the poorest postal code in Canada, Vancouver's downtown east side. Insight operates on a harm reduction model.
We're trying to keep people as healthy as possible. My job isn't to make people be abstinent. My job is to keep them healthier, which is a realizable goal for a facility like this.
Insight was mandated by a Liberal government as a research study and has since been operating under a Conservative government. Despite Stephen Harper's contention that taxpayers' money should not go to facilitating drug use, widespread support for the site, bolstered by several studies showing that the site is making strides in harm reduction, has resulted in the government postponing a decision to shutter it.
Every dollar is invested in this injection site, and we have a $3 million budget every year. It saves $4 for the healthcare system right now.
Vancouver police appear to be on side with the safe injection site, urging users to avail of services there rather than using in alleys.
And instead of arresting them or jacking them up for their drugs, they'll actually bring them to the site and say, here you go, get yourself signed up and you have a place to inject.
Drugs have been readily available in the downtown east side since long before the arrival of Insight. Will opening a safe injection site in Victoria, where users are spread out more evenly, create an epicenter for those who prey on the vulnerable? Having seen the results of failed experiments with several needle exchanges in their city, the Victoria PD are reluctant to get behind a fixed safe injection site and instead advocate the mobile needle exchanges currently in operation in the city. They often find themselves caught in a battle between their duty to the law and the medical needs of addicts.
We just want to find a solution and one that works, so just clarity is what we desire. You know.
A safe injection site modeled after Vancouver's Insight is a potential solution to the problems posed by IV drug use in Victoria. But is it an ethical solution? The primary concern of safe injection sites is harm reduction. But do such sites maximize good and minimize harm for all those affected?
How do you make a safe injection site successful, both from the client's perspective and the community's perspective? People argue that, you know, there's that issue around harm reduction between both to the client users, but also what's the harm reduction to the neighborhood.
The Victoria Police Department argue opening a safe injection site would bring more harm than good to those who aren't clients of the site.
If you look right now where we have needle distribution and distribution of crack pipes and things like that, it's spread out. We have mobile exchanges and things like that, and we find that works very well, just to not centralize one issue in one place.
Even proponents of such a site, like Mayor Dean Fortin, acknowledge this issue.
You either have to like do a red zone area or do a bubble which says, to be effective, we don't deal with any social disorders issues around here, because you can't say come and use your drugs here, but you have to run through 14 police officers or everyone to interfere with that.
A byproduct of creating a bubble is that while harm reduction services are made available to addicts, their vulnerabilities may be more likely to be exposed and taken advantage of in an area that houses a safe injection site.
There's a lot of predatory activity that happens for clients that use drugs that also, frankly, need an opportunity for safety as well.
Still, it's hard to argue that many of the harms associated with IV drug use can be minimized by the presence of a safe injection site. Overdose deaths in the immediate vicinity of Insight have dropped 35% since it opened. The number of public injections in the vicinity of Insight have also dropped, as has the amount of IV drug-related litter in the area. Another question to ask when examining the ethics of safe injection sites is, Are the people affected by them able to make their own choices?
Any time that you have any sort of civic institution set up, it is a case of individual choices is always starts to be subservient a little to the collective will.
By saying it's okay to shoot up in one place but not okay in another, are we creating different classes of addicts by commending those who choose to go to a safe injection site? Do we stigmatize addicts based on where they choose to shoot up? Is that fair, and does it respect the addict's right to choose where they get high? Mayor Fortin and others argue the pursuit of harm reduction sometimes trumps the right to choose.
We make these choices and balances all the time. So, you know, you want to walk around your own home with completely naked with your pants off? That's fine. We don't allow you generally to do that in downtown streets of Victoria.
In order to really minimize harm to IV drug users, a more comprehensive approach to harm reduction may be necessary. A safe injection site can be part of a harm reduction strategy, but equally important are the accompanying issues of prevention, treatment, and enforcement.
There are a lot of other factors that come into a reduction in calls for service or crime or increased feelings of safety.
Adequate housing is the cornerstone of stability that allows a person to manage addiction.
Drug use drops about 25% to 50% of drug use drops when you get people into housing.
A lack of treatment options hinders efforts to combat addiction. While a safe injection site should provide a safe place to get high, it should also be a stepping stone to finding shelter, receiving treatment, and fostering positivity in the community.
You can do the upload and do the front end stuff, but when you need to do that follow through, we're just sorely lacking on the island.
Unfortunately, sometimes it seems like we're just working on two pillars, which is, you know, needles and policing. We recognize that safe injection sites are part of a larger system-wide approach to the use of drugs.
Only by addressing all four pillars, harm reduction, enforcement, treatment, and prevention, will Victoria's intravenous drug problem be improved.